Wow. Powerbait, VMC hooks, and heads. We are going to be fishing the chicken rig today, so maybe I should wear this one.
What are you feeling?
You know, it's the fall, and in the fall, covering water, imitating a shad is very key. So, a couple spinner baits, of course, the lover spinner bait, the water slash spinner bait, and cranking is the primary deal. And the particular lake that we're fishing, we're going to be fishing a lot of 4 to 6 foot water, so a DT4. I want to pull a few of those, and also a DT6. You're going to notice everything in shad color. And last but not least, fall's very, very known for this style of bait. Not just in the spring, but also in the fall. And that is a lipless crankbait. This is a Rip and Wrap by Rapala. Always want to throw in some lipless baits. It's pretty good. I like that. Maybe a couple jerk baits, just to keep them honest too. You know what I mean? Gotta keep them honest with jerk bait. So, doing a couple shadow wrap shads. All right.
What do we got? All the new brat colors and every size. Every size, every color. Three of each. We got options for brats.
Got also, you know, it's like, this is like a tackle shopping in the morning. Could also get a little spike it. I never go anywhere without spike it. Very, very important. Sometimes you gotta modify that bait just a little bit. There's a lot of really good spike it stuff, but this is, you know, probably three of my favorite. Of course, just a chartreuse dye, chartreuse and orange, top two key colors. This is actually just a little super glue. They call it a fix-a-lure. It's got a brush applicator, so swim baits start breaking up, you can fix them. But here's the hottest new product I've been fishing right here. This is called Luma Pearl. It's actually in a spray, and you can spray any kind of bait. Crankbait, soft bait, even a spinnerbait blade, and it gives it a pearlescent sheen. In the fall, when they're feeding on bait, and bait gets more key than, say, crawfish, that Luma Pearl spray is the deal. You're gonna see that work today, for sure. So here we are, we're in South Jersey. Believe it or not, it looks like we could be in Iowa, but this is New Jersey, it's Southern New Jersey. It's fall. You can see all the leaves changing. The air temperature, water temperature starting to get really cool. We're headed to a lake that's real special to me. It's a lake in South Jersey that I essentially learned how to bass fish. You know, started bass fishing when I was 12, but when I really started cutting my teeth on these new techniques, spinnerbait, crankbait, jig, this is the lake I learned. So this is a lake that we call Lake A. And just like A starts in the beginning of the alphabet, this is where it all started for me, right here. But of course, no day on fishing in South Jersey wouldn't be complete without a trip to Wawa! Wawa! Wawa!
Essentials.
So here we go, we're right at here at Lake A, getting ready to launch. It's a cold, crisp morning. It's the fall. And we got a couple conditions either working for us or against us. If you look up in the sky, this is so typical of what's called a post-frontal situation. No clouds, high pressure, pressure's rising. That tends to make the fishing tough. But what's working for us is it's the fall. We have a fall drawdown going on this lake right now. If you look at this wall or these rocks, you're gonna see this lake level's down 2 or 3 feet. So the bait's gonna be concentrated, the bass should be eating them, preparing for the winter time. This should be a good day of fishing. That's the thing in the fall, everything revolves around bait. You know, it's like other times of the year, they get keyed in on crawfish or whatever, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, this time of year, it really, everything centers around bait fish. And in this particular lake, that means it's shad, a threadfin shad, and some gizzard shad. So this is a real good bait. Too many people think that a lipless is only a spring bait, but it's an amazing fall bait as well. Cover a ton of water. It may be the kind of day where you find a group. You know, they do. They'll get bunched up in the fall. It's also the kind of day where I want to use a hydro wave, again, because it's a bait fish deal. Go on a power pattern. This time of the year, it's funny because it's important to have electronics, but you use your eyes a lot in the fall. You know, I'm using my eyes. Just, there's one. Small one. First fish of the day, though. We just changed banks. We got around a bank that has a little more bait. It's not a very big one, but that's actually a really small one, but it's the first sign of the day. That's okay. That's okay. Right there, my Micropolis salmoides. Little ripping rat. That's okay, that's a good sign. I was just mentioning, you know, we made a move real quick to this bank because we see a lot of bait visually with our eyes. And that's real important in the fall. You know, in the fall time of the year when they're feeding on bait fish, it's so important to keep your eyes open more than any other time of the year because, you know, those little dimples that you see, that's telling you where that bait's at. You know, in the fall when you find that bait fish, you're gonna find the bass. And it's as simple as that, you know. That's good, that was first cast. It's gotta find an area with a lot of them. Right. Big one on chicken rig. Oh God, no! That was a giant. Broke me off. Yep, broke it at the leader. That's my own fault, who knows last time I retied it, you know? Oh my God. Another big one. Big one. On the chicken rig. Big one on the chicken rig. Two in a row now. Don't you do it. Oh God, a big one. This is classic, classic finesse fishing. Not with the Neko rig, with the chicken rig. This is a different, it's a big one too. Oh, big one. This is such a cool way to catch him. Oh God, look at that. God, stay on there. The great thing about this hook I'm using, it's a VMC Neko hook, Neko Finesse. And it's the perfect hook for Neko rigging or chicken rigging. Look at that thing. Come on. Got him. I got him. Look at that thing. God, look at it. Down his throat. Nice. First nice fish of the day. And I want you to see where, look at that chicken rig in his mouth. This is why this lure is so effective. And this hook, that Neko hook, here it goes. VMC Finesse Neko. The style of that hook keeps these fish pinned. It's a good first one of the day right there. Look at that. Nice 3-pound class fish on the chicken rig. There he goes. I want to show you this bait. I want to talk about it because it's such a unique rig. It is not traditional Neko rigging. It's a weedless modification of a Neko rig called the chicken rig. Starts with the hook, VMC number one, number two, or one-aught finesse Neko hook. It's the perfect hook for this style of thing. The bait, you can use a soft stick bait, but this is the one that I designed for Berkley Powerbait. It's called a flute worm. And this worm is so good for the chicken rig because of that fluted tail, that very thin tail, but especially because of that real bulbous head. Look at that fat head. And I'm gonna show you why that's key. In the chicken rig, you wanna tail weight it. And I'm using just an insert weight by VMC. And unlike a regular nail, it has a rounded edge to it. And there's more surface area.
And this technique, the chicken rig, what's key is when that weight is ticking the bottom, it actually pecks, ding, 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 ding. So that rounded weight's key. But here's what I want to show you, okay? And it's the rigging style. And what we're going to do is we're going to start like it's an inline wacky. But instead of just leaving it exposed and wacky, we're going to pull all the way through and start a Texas rig. And the nice thing about the flute worm is I use these high ridges as markers. So I go in the middle high ridge, and I'm going to come out of the second high ridge and just Texas rig it. And that little bump out on the flute worm actually acts as a protector of the hook. So now when you look at the chicken rig, you immediately see the difference between this and a Neko or Neko rig. It's in line, but it's weedless. So you get that same ticking on the bottom, but you can throw it anywhere. Trees, under docks, around bridges, and it won't snag. And that right there, that's the chicken rig. That thing is awesome. Chicken rig again. Big fish. Oh. Wow, this is so fun catching my light line. Oh God, big one. Look at that. Once again, that Neko finesse hook by VMC. 99.9% of the time, when you got them, you got them. You just take your time and fight them on that light line. Look at that. It's 8-pound Berkley Trilene Fluorocarbon Leader attached to a 10-pound Berkley X5 braid. Another good one on the chicken. I got it. Look at that. Look at that thing. Look at the heads on these fish. Look where that hook is at again, down his throat. It proves how much they like this chicken rig. And there's two key parts to it. The one is, I can barely get it out. The one is that weight, that's that Neko half moon, pecking, ding, 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 ding. But the other thing on this flute worm, I want you to take a look at that tail. It's a single-sided tapered tail on the flute worm. So it's scooped on one side without it even being in the water. And that's just me holding it. Look at the action of that tail. So the combination of the pecking and that tail, rig chicken style, produces a lot of fish. Another nice one right there. Beautiful. We're targeting, this is a key area, we're targeting a funnel area, which is a bridge. It's got a little bit of a washout, a little deeper water. And with the low water conditions, sometimes they'll stack up on places like this. But this setup is really, really key. It's 8-pound Berkley Trilene, 100% fluorocarbon leader to a 10-pound Berkley X5 braid. Real important, that setup. And then the rod and reel is real key. This is an Abu Garcia Ike Revo spinning reel in the 30 size. Lets me put a lot of line on. And the chicken rig or a Neko rig, I love to fish it on a longer spinning rod. A 7.4 to a 7.8 rod is what I like. This one happens to be the 7.6 medium action Abu Garcia Ike finesse rod, and it's perfect. You know, because that longer rod, when these fish bite, I'm not jacking them, you know? When I make that cast out there and that fish starts carrying it away, I'm not jacking the hook. I'm actually just leaning back into them. So that long rod really loads up real nice for this kind of fishing. You know, as far as how I'm fishing it, I'll give you the whole rundown here. I'm getting this chicken rig and I can make a cast here. Getting this chicken rig and I'm casting it to that target. And I'm letting it sink all the way to the bottom. So watching that line as it falls. As soon as I see that line hit the bottom, I'm doing a ton, big one. Nope, it's not a big one, it's a good one. I'm doing a ton of shaking. You saw me shaking my rod tip on that one. A chicken rig and a Neko rig is all about shaking the rod because you want, that's a decent one. You want that bait pecking. Okay. That one I could probably swing. There you go. This bait is all about shaking your rod because that weight is pecking on the bottom It's making dust come up. It's making the bottom kind of stir. And then that little single-sided tail I was talking about, as you're shaking your rod, that thing's going crazy. So chicken rig and Neko rig, you want to do a lot of shaking. Again, this rod, 7'6", a longer rod, helps with that shaking and that hook set. Don't jack it, just slowly get into that fish. It's a decent one. Cannot believe how many are in this one little spot. I told you in the fall, dude, sometimes they just gang up. With the water being low, it makes a lot of sense, you know?
There you go.
Another one on the chicken, right where they're supposed to be hooked. It's like every time, if you look at that hook, the design of that hook is so unique, it keeps them pinned every time. All right, this is where when you start to feel, the fish start to feel the pressure of the same bait. This is where it's good to have a lot of rods rigged. You notice the bite has slowed a little and it seems like the size of our fish is getting a little smaller. So this is where I like to start showing them something different. When you have a group of fish, it's good to have a couple different alternate baits rigged. Let's see, oh God, that was unreal. See that? It literally spun around like 20 times. So nervous because I want to cast under her again. I wanted to go to the jig. See, you know, the last couple bites seemed a little like they turned up a little smaller. Let's go to a jig and see if we can get bit big. It might be all about that finesse. You know, we're gonna see here. So another good reason to switch is didn't take long. Small one on the jig. So great, this is a great little lesson though. You know, when you have a concentration of fish, a lot of times it happens in the spring and the fall, like we have here, just keep switching. And look how far that is down his throat. That's not a big one, but look how far that's down his throat. And I want to show you this bait. It's really unique. I can barely get it out. Let this go real quick and I'll show you this bait. Everybody knows the success of the missile jigs, the mini flip, and of course the micro jig. And this is a new concept jig that is a combination of a football and a micro style jig. This is the missile jigs micro football. So it's got a football style head, super broad, wide shoulders on the head to help it go through rock and cover. It's got a 90 degree line tie, fine weed guards at a perfect angle. And then it's got that little tiny finesse hook. Look at that thing. Just a real small, super sharp Japanese style hook. And there's a lot of cool different ways, different trailers you can use. But this is my favorite right here. This is Berkley Powerbait Water Bug, brand new bait I helped design. And I literally bite the thing in half. If you look at it, this is the tail section, but it's really special. The Water Bug has these rabbit ear style flappers on the back and it gives it a little subtle motion. So I just bite that down, thread that thing on the back of that micro football, and it's just a perfect little compliment bait on the back. You're getting down to the wire here though, on size. You're supposed to get bigger ones on the jig and we're getting smaller ones. I don't know what that's all about. Let's see. A couple more casts and I think I might push through just a little bit. I hate to run them over, but I also don't want to sit here and catch 12 inches the rest of the day. A little better? Yeah, it's a little better. Yeah. Another good one on a micro football. There's that little water bug sitting on the back. It's like that perfect complement. You know, the whole key to the micro football is a compact package. When these fish start eating small crawfish and little bluegill, you just get so many more bites versus a full-size jig. And that little water bug trailer is too much action for them. They can't stand it. A little nice little fat one.
If you like what you're watching in this week's episode of the Tackle Warehouse Vlogs, like, share, and tag a friend.
to be entered into the contest to win great gear. Also, if you like the equipment and products used in this video, you can get everything on Tackle Warehouse.